Hello everyone and welcome to Red United TV. It's your boy Ivorian Spice back at it again with your latest Manchester United news. And for those who are new to this channel, remember to subscribe, smash that like button, remember to share, and for those who want to contribute, link description in the comment section as well, and also in the links description for the link to PayPal, and of course catch me on your live to give you that super chat, guys. But yes, it is your Manchester latest news in the smallest segment of them all. So, of course, guys, if you do like this show, always remember to subscribe and share as well and follow the socials. We have news on the game against Brighton, news on Kieran McKenna's future, also news on Anthony Elanga and Elan Messler from Leeds and Anthony Martial. But we must start it off with one of the biggest news, of course, guys. If you're looking to watch Manchester United play football on the weekend, it ain't happening. It is not happening because the game itself has been postponed due to a COVID outbreak. This was released today via all social media platforms, including Manchester United homepage and, of course, Sky Sports News, who broke it earlier on the day. Which I have to say, I am slightly disappointed that Manchester United's match won't be going on, but health comes first. And if it's not right for these players to go out there while COVID cases are soaring up, then it doesn't make sense that she should be playing. It's only fair they should. But the news came from Sky Sports News, guys, which says right here, Manchester United versus Brighton postponed. As always, let me share my screen. Manchester United versus Brighton postponed, but Premier League intends to continue fixture schedules where safely possible. So what it means is that if the cases regarding COVID is not high and etc., and the teams as well that don't have a high record of positive COVID tests, especially the PCR, then after discussion, they can continue and they can play. But as we speak right now, the Premier League are not really in favor of postponing every single match, especially when it was locked down and it really hurt. So, and I think it's a money thing right now, you know, for all the broadcasting, etc. But as you can see here, guys, the game against Brentford was postponed. But the game against Burnley versus what? I mean, the game against Brentford was postponed. The game against Burnley versus Watford was postponed. And the Leicester versus Tottenham has also been postponed as we speak now. So it means on the weekend, as Manchester United fans, you better spend some time with your family, you know. Tell your baby, babes, what are we doing this weekend? I'm going to take you out. Because Manchester United are not playing, guys. They really ain't. But it is what it is, guys, with Manchester United not playing. Let me know what your thoughts are on it, guys. For those who have just found out, are you happy? Are you sad? Or you understand? For those, let me know in the comments description. And the second news of today, guys, is Kieran McKenna, who has been linked with the Ipswich manager job, and he has been given permission by Manchester United themselves to speak to Ipswich. And as we speak right now, he's in conversation. There's also a coach that's been highly ranked and highly thought of at Manchester United that will be joining Kieran McKenna. And I'm about to share the screen. As you can see, this comes from Manchester United Evening News. It says that Manchester United give coach Kieran McKenna permission to talk to Ipswich over vacant manager job. And it says that Manchester United's first team coach set to leave the club after he asked to speak to Ipswich about their managerial vacancy. And Kieran is still here after the departure of Michael Carrick and the sacking of Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, who was part of that coaching team. Many people have asked and questioned, why is Kieran McKenna still here? He needs to go. He's part of that losing team. Yes, and I agree, he needs to go. We're also wondering, Phelan, you're possibly next. You need to get your scrubbish ass out of here. And as you see there, and I'm reporting from Manchester United Evening News, if I read the top, it says, Manchester United have given McKenna permission to hold talks with Ipswich after he told the club he was keen on taking the position. See, you might as well leave, innit? The League One outfit sacked Paul Cook earlier in December and have identified McKenna as the ideal candidate to replace him as they seek to close the gap on playoff pace. McKenna told United new interim manager Ralph Rangnick he was interested in the job, and the German has given his blessing to the departure of the 35-year-old. It's understood that Rangnick had enjoyed working with MCKENNA, who was sat next to the manager at Carroll Road on Saturday, but he accepts that the chance of moving into a managerial position was too good to turn down. Good on you, MCKENNA, you know, trying to sort out your future, guy. Your future, man. Sort your future out, improve, because here at Manchester United, they do not respect you. They don't respect your wishes. They say your coaching is elementary, childish. It's like you're still managing the under 18 and you're still like a PE teacher. You know the word PE teacher did actually make sense, come to think about it, because they said it was school-like, elementary type of coaching, which meant technically we had a bunch of PE teachers managing and coaching Manchester United. But in terms of my opinion, guys, I don't know how you think of it and whether you think that Kieran MCKENNA will be a great loss, because I don't really think so. You know, under the stewardship with Ollie and Carrick, they were all failures. The football wasn't good and the development of the players wasn't really good as well. Players were stagnated. They stagnated so many times. But in despite that, guys, you let me know what your thoughts on MCKENNA. The next news that comes with Anthony Elanga. Anthony Elanga is due to sign a contract extension. Not so long ago of signing one during the end of last season, but as you speak now, Elanga himself is set to sign a new deal, as you said, for just 9 months after his last deal. Elanga has been impressing. I don't know what your guys' opinion on Elanga right now, because I still think he's a young prospect who's learning. You know, I don't have much of a high thoughts of Elanga, because I also think other Manchester United players, academy players, can do a better job. But it says here that, coming from, again, the Manchester Evening News, make sure you subscribe or make sure you follow them as well. The Swedish forward only signed the latest contract with the club 9 months ago, but is set to be rewarded with updated terms after an impressive calendar year, which I don't know what was impressive. I need to know, because, of course, himself, Elanga has featured 5 times for the senior side since his breakthrough, and interim manager Ralf Rangnick is understood to be a fond admirer. He did come on the game against Palace when he made that change, I believe. The game that we won 1-0 against Norwich as well. Did come on, and he also played in the Champions League game as well. So, and I'm sorry, game against Palace and also the Champions League game, the last game against Young, where he did start. But apart from that, I don't really know what to be a fond admirer of, because I'm in that position. I'm in that mind and that thoughts, guys, that Elanga's not really it. He really isn't it, to me, in my opinion. I don't know, guys. You guys let me know what your thoughts on the situation with Elanga. Do you feel like Man United should be rewarding, or they should be waiting, guys? Another guy that has been linked with Manchester United, as you can see here, guys, is Leeds goalkeeper, Ilan Meslier. He's been linked for a while for Manchester United, and Manchester United have sent scouts. I will bring that news to you guys as we see here. As you can see here, United sent goalkeeper scout to watch Ilan Meslier. United sent goalkeeper scout Tony Cotton to watch Ilan Meslier. According to a report, the Daily Mail claims that United scout were in attendance at the French youngster conceded 7 times against Man City. Whoa, he conceded 7 times against Man City. I think he just needs to just stop there. I know Leeds defense is a bit shaky. It's not his fault that his team conceded 7 goals. But they have suggested that United identified the 21-year-old as the best young keeper in the country. Maybe for the time when, you know, David De Gea himself leaves, or Henderson's had enough, maybe they will go for the young French goalkeeper. But in my opinion, we shall wait and see whether it's real news, whether it's fake news. We will find out, guys. My big up to you guys who are watching right now as well. Make sure you subscribe, smash that like button. But we move it on to the last news, which regards to the future of Anthony Martial, who is technically, as we're speaking right now, trying to force a move to a Serie A giant. This is coming from Stretti News on the One Football app. Make sure you download the One Football app for your latest Manchester United news, guys. Yes, it appears that he has ended the likes and any bad relationship, a point of no return for Manchester United. Apparently, tweet yesterday, Manchester United have broken up with Anthony Martial. But yes, as you can read right here, Anthony Martial has broken up with United ahead of what he hopes will be a January transfer window, just weeks after Ralf Rangnick's appointment as interim. The reports also suggest that Martial is now looking to force through a move to Juventus, where he seems
seemingly thinks the grass is greener. And as you see that United Reports did tweet yesterday that Man United have broken up with Anthony Martial and he wants away immediately or loan or outright. Whichever way, it is what it is. Martial hasn't been impressive in the last 6 years. He's been inconsistent, guys. And I don't mind if he was to leave. It is time for Martial to go, to move on, because these players haven't really been it. You guys let me know what your thoughts on Anthony Martial, whether he should stay or whether he should go. But this has been your latest Manchester United news. Make sure you like and subscribe if you like the video and you've watched it to the end. Make sure you share, make sure you follow all the social media accounts of Red United TV, including my own personal social media account on Instagram and Twitter. But it has been your latest news. This has been your boy, Avorin Spice, and I'm out. I shall see you next time. Peace!